Mark, it seems like every big tech company has been unveiling some kind of new robotics venture as of late. How does Google stack up?
Yeah, I've been trying to tell everyone on here, robotics, consumer robotics is the next big thing in the industry, right? We had autonomous cars, we had mixed reality, AR glasses, we have voice, right? But artificial intelligence is going to be at the core of everything. And really, the ultimate hardware expression of AI is robotics, right? Being able to understand how a human acts, right? Artificially learn from data, right? And mimic a human. And that is what a robot is, right? And so you've seen Tesla play in this space. Now you're seeing Meta make a big investment in that space. And now today, Google is announcing new Gemini models and infrastructure specific to powering robots. So all of these companies want to play in this space. Meta announced versions of Llama, right? And a big investment to build consumer robots and to be at the center of everything. Meta wants to be the future operating system to power these robots, but they're going to have a big competitor here with Google, right? Who has experience building operating systems for first-party and third-party hardware. And obviously, Gemini is right up there with Llama and ChatGPT and the other AI systems. So this is a big deal not only for Google, but the industry at large.
So, Mark, how convincing is this push? Because we have seen Google try, or Alphabet try, to get into the robot world before. My understanding is that they shut down a spinoff company that was associated with this. So this time around, what's the difference and how big is the push?
I think the difference this time is Gemini, right? The underlying AI technology is much different. It's much more advanced. It's more reputable, right? And now appears to be the time where companies are willing to put in the proper investment, the necessary infrastructure to make robotics happen, right? Waymo has been pretty successful comparatively in the industry. And so what you're seeing is a lot of data collection there, a lot of experience in autonomy and cameras, and that's technology that Google could ultimately use if it wanted to build its own humanoid. But don't count out Apple. Apple has Skunk Works teams working on humanoid robots as well. The big difference is they're not going to publicly release an underlying robotic model, right, in order to support third-party robots and other consumer hardware. They're going to go all in-house. They're going to follow the Tesla method that you've seen from the Tesla bot over the past couple of years. So at some point in the next 5 to 10 years, you're going to see real competition between Google, Meta, Apple, Tesla, the Chinese companies, and others in consumer robots. So stay tuned. This is going to be a really big deal. And some of those movies we've seen over the last several decades, they're starting to come to reality.